Hi again, everyone. Mike Conrad here, founder and CEO of Aqueous Technologies and host of the, right here, Reliability Matters podcast with you once again for more tips and tricks for cleaning circuit assemblies. Most of us are familiar with the term ECM or electrochemical migration. Many of us are also aware that the presence of ECM can lead to dendritic growth and parasitic electrical leakage. Many of us, however, are unaware of how ECM specifically creates a failure mechanism. On this episode of Tips and Tricks for Cleaning Circuit Assemblies, I'll dive into the chemistry of ECM failures, how they occur, and perhaps most importantly, how to prevent ECM failures. And we'll do all that when I return in just a moment. Stick around. Dendrites, in the context of electrochemical migration on circuit assemblies, refer to the growth of conductive metal filaments, often made of materials like copper, silver, or tin, which can occur under certain conditions. These dendritic growths stem from the movement of metal ions under the influence of an electric field, a process that is often accelerated in the presence of moisture and various contaminants. These dendrites form as a result of two main phenomena. Electrochemical migration is the movement of metal ions due to the momentum transfer between conducting electrons and diffusing metal atoms. It occurs under the influence of a strong electric field, typically found in densely packed circuitry. Over time, this movement can lead to the formation of electrically conductive dendritic structures. Corrosion or chemical migration happens due to chemical reactions, often involving moisture or other contaminants. These reactions can cause metal ions to dissolve from one part of the circuit and to be deposited in another, forming conductive dendritic structures. The growth of dendrites in electronic circuit assemblies is a significant reliability concern because these structures can bridge adjacent conductors, leading to short circuits and failures. This is particularly problematic in miniaturized electronic devices where the spacing between conductors is very small, making them more susceptible to such issues. Preventing dendritic growth involves careful control of materials, manufacturing processes, and operating environments to minimize the factors that contribute to electrochemical migration and corrosion. But there is good news. And the good news is the removal of contamination from circuit assemblies after reflow eliminates all possibilities of electrochemical migration and the resulting failure mechanisms. An important preventative measure against electrochemical migration in circuit assemblies is the cleaning of these assemblies after reflow soldering. This step is crucial for several reasons. Flux used in soldering can leave residues on the circuit board, even so-called no-clean fluxes. These residues can absorb moisture from the air, which can facilitate electrochemical migration. Cleaning the circuit assembly after reflow soldering helps remove these potentially conductive residues. During the soldering process, other contaminants like oils, greases, particulates, and human contaminants can accumulate on the circuit board. These contaminants can result from board and component fabrication processes, assembly processes, humans touching the boards, and other sources. These contaminants can act as a catalyst for electrochemical reactions, thereby increasing the risk of dendritic formation. Proper cleaning removes these contaminants. Cleaning also helps in reducing the overall moisture content on the circuit assembly by removing specific contaminant species that are hydroscopic. Residues which are hydroscopic can attract and hold water molecules via either absorption or adsorption from the surrounding environment, which is usually at normal or room temperatures. Moisture is a key factor in electrochemical migration as it can dissolve metal ions and facilitate their movement, leading to dendritic growth. While the absence of moisture eliminates any ECM potential, moisture barriers are not an ideal method for ECM prevention. It's widely believed that by applying a conformal coating to an assembly, that will eliminate the possibility of moisture intrusion. This is not accurate, as most conformal coating materials are permeable and will allow small amounts of moisture to permeate through the coating, resulting in an ECM event. Case in point, here's a photograph of a dendrite growing on a surface of a component under conformal coating, proving the presence of moisture. By removing potential sources of contamination and moisture, cleaning enhances overall reliability of the circuit assembly. It reduces the likelihood of short circuits and other electrical failures that can result from dendritic growth. Did you know clean circuit assemblies exhibit more consistent electrical properties? Contaminants and residues can alter the conductive paths and resistance values, leading to unpredictable circuit behavior. It's important to use appropriate cleaning methods and solutions that are effective in removing flux and other contaminants without damaging the circuit assembly. The choice of a specific cleaning method depends on the type of flux used, the assembly's material, the level of cleanliness required, the required throughput, and many other factors. Proper drying after cleaning is also essential to ensure that no moisture is trapped in or on the assembly, which could later contribute to electrochemical migration. Well, I hope you found this topic helpful. Please keep your questions and topic suggestions coming. Send them right down here to my email address, and be sure and listen to or watch the Reliability Matters podcast. We currently have more than 130 episodes with more than 80,000 episodes downloaded. Check them out on your favorite podcast app. You can also watch the Reliability Matters podcast on, where? The Reliability Matters YouTube channel. While watching, be sure to click the like, subscribe, and bell icons to be notified when new episodes are released. We release new episodes on the second and fourth Tuesday of every month. Thanks so much for watching. Until I see you again, stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, and perhaps most importantly, keep doing it right. And I'll see you again very soon.